This light. Is someone inside?
Ah! Willy the Wisp! The ghostly torch that burns endlessly inside empty offices!
You! Give it a rest already!
I can't help it. Ghost stories are my only real fear, you know?
Then stop telling them! I can't even tell if you're trying to scare us or yourself!
Settle down, everyone. Let's just head inside, okay?
Could it be? Inconceivable.
Meow.
But the stars, they speak to me.
Pardon me, Professor?
And yet, so many mysteries they have yet to reveal. 1, 2, 6 lights? Whatever could these be?
Professor!
Oh, who goes there? Well, well, if it isn't you again.
Wait, you're the old fortune teller from Eternia.
What are you doing here, Pops?
Why would I be anywhere else? This is, after all, my own office.
Your office? You're Professor Norzin?
Very astute, six-star scholar Eugene Yolger. You're the 23rd in our school's history, you know.
What?
I am Professor Norzin Horoskov, a specialist in astrology and the arcane. In my spare time, I enjoy ballroom dancing and gardening.
Keep that in mind. So, what were you doing in Eternia anyway?
The stars spoke to me of a great calamity that would threaten our world. And so, I traveled to Eternia that I might find a way to awaken the hero Tiz Aurier. But then the Empire struck, making it all but impossible to reach Tiz on my own. Once more, I looked to the heavens for guidance. And this time, I was able to bring 4 stars together.
So it was you that led my friends to me, who helped them wake me from my slumber. You have my thanks, Professor Norzin.
Ho ho! The miracle, Tiz Aurier, in the flesh. And this is our other star. Mm-hmm. 'Twas a harbinger of good fortune after all.
Hmm? Actually, we had a question for you, Professor.
Yes, my boy?
We're trying to get to the Skyhold, but a massive sandstorm is swirling around the nation of Anshine. We can't even get close. Do you know some way to quiet the winds?
Why, that I do. Most indubitably.
All right!
Oh, well, please tell us, Professor.
Heed my words well, my boy. I know how to quiet the storm, because it is I who summoned it.
Professor? I must have misheard you.
It wasn't the Kaiser who caused the sandstorm, but you?
Just so. With it, I will bring the Skyhold down. While guiding the 4 of you to the Skyhold, I was also exploring ways to vanquish the Empire on my own. After much research, Eureka! It came to me! Using the power of this crystal, I would unleash a great sandstorm! A sandstorm of such fearsome force that it would rip the Skyhold from the sky and send it crashing to the Earth, Kaiser and all!
Hold it right there, Pops! What's going to happen to the people of Anshine?
Many lives will be lost, no doubt. And yet it is a risk we must take. After all, the Kaiser and the Skyhold are within my sphere of arcane influence. It would be pure folly to let him escape unscathed. For the future of Luxendark, the people of Anshine will make the most noble of all sacrifices.
Mikhail Coulot! How could you?
But, Professor, Pope Agnes is in the Skyhold too. You mean to sacrifice not only the people of Anshim, but Her Holiness as well?
My boy, I wish there were no need, but the stars have spoken. This is the only way. And so I shall heed the heavens. I will bring down the Empire no matter the cost. I do not expect you to understand. I have chosen my path, and I will follow it.
I see. And we must do the same.
Yes, and I think our choice is clear.
We'll defend Her Holiness and the people of Anshim. Just watch us.
Oh, impressive resolve, boy. And yet resolve and lofty ideals are all but worthless in the hands of the weak. Do you have the strength to realize your ideals, boy? Then summon that strength and defeat me, holder of the Astrologian Asterisk. Do you truly possess the power to overthrow the Kaiser? To save Pope Agnes and the people of Anshim? Or are those just empty vows? I, Norzan, shall be the arbiter of your worth! I am Norzan of Stars Innumerable, Professor Emeritus of Alcampus, and holder of the Astrologian Asterisk. Let your final examination begin!
Do you truly believe what you're doing is right? That the goal of defeating the Kaiser justifies this terrible sacrifice?
How little you understand, my boy. 2.5 years ago, when the crystals were swallowed by darkness, I could only stand by and watch as brave men and women fought for their own beliefs, their own sense of justice. I sat here in my office, unsure as to which side to lend my strength. In doing nothing, I brought only greater tragedy. I will not repeat my mistake. This time, I will trust my own sense of justice. I will take action!
I used to feel the same way. I thought nothing was more important than sticking to my own sense of justice.
We fought on, and the people around us paid the price for our actions. We want to make a different choice this time. The choice not to sacrifice others for our beliefs.
Thank you.
you.
You are strong, my children.
Professor, we beg of you, please, stop the sandstorm. We'll defeat the Kaiser. There's no need for the people of Anshim to suffer any longer.
It would seem you have something to back up those words after all. You have passed your test with flying colors. 'Twould seem that I was the one who lacked the courage of my convictions after all. To tell the truth, Anshim is where I was born so many years ago. The last thing I wanted was to see my beloved home come to harm. And yet, consumed with remorse and regret, I had convinced myself that the sandstorm was the only way. Through your strength and your words, you have shown me that there is another. You, children, are the future. I put my trust and faith in you.
We did it!
But before you depart for Anshim, there is one more task I would ask of you.
A task?
The compass of space and time, a storied relic of ancient Harina. I would have you recover it. Ever since the Skyhold arrived in these lands, it has been drifting to and fro and to, almost as if it were searching for something. After days of poring through the histories and nights of speaking to the stars, it came to me. The compass! The Kaiser seeks the compass!
The compass? Of space and time?
The compass has the power to reshape our very world. We must keep it from the Kaiser at all costs. If the tomes speak true, the compass rests in the sea caves of Harina. You must travel south, past the desert, then east through the forests from the Altar of Wind. Now hurry, you must find the compass before the Kaiser.
A compass? A compass? A compass, you say? Meow, there's a tail I'm glad I caught.
That voice.
Mew! Didn't Mew notice? Fluffy here was keeping tabbies on Mew. And Mew just happened to cough up a beaut about some compass of strays and lime. Oh, his Meowtesty will be so pleased.
You're the girl we saw fishing.
Minette is his Meowtesty the Kaiser's master of cats and a trained Meowsassin. Cats are great. They never betray Mew. Cats are great. They leave Mew alone. Cats are great. They get by on their meown. Meow.
Look out, everyone!
Sick 'em, Fluffy.
Professor!
Attaboy, Fluffy. Meow. See? Cats everywhere are my friends.
Professor! Are you okay? Professor!
This should put that sandstorm back in the litter box. I need to inform his Meowjesty. I'll be back for Mew later. Ta-ta for Meow!
Allah, shut! Should we go after her?
Let her go. The professor needs our help.
Hang in there, Pops. Here, let me see your wounds.
Oh,
Worry not for me, my child. I have seen it in the stars. I am not so foolish as to misread the day of my own demise. Mayhap this is the price I pay for putting my pride above the lives of my countrymen.
No, this can't be happening.
Do not look so sad, my boy. This path I chose for myself. You too must follow your path, my children. For your path will lead not to pain, but to a bright future.
Yes, Professor.
Oh, that's the spirit, my shining stars. And as my own star dims, I ask you once more, find the compass. Whatever may come, you must keep it out of the Kaiser's hands.
I understand. You can count on us, Professor.
That I do, my stars. And let the shining light of your ideals guide us to a brighter tomorrow.
Yes, and follow through on our words.
Thank you, Magnolia. And forgive me.
Hmm? Como? Whatever for?
The ball in the Skyhole destroyed your home, right? It's your sworn mission to defeat it. If we hadn't stopped the Professor Sandstorm, you could have accomplished this already. You could have had your revenge.
You, listen to me. My home on the moon was destroyed by that ball. This is the undeniable reality. And it is true, destroying that ball and avenging my people is my mission. Before I left the moon, my commander spoke to me. You are strong, he said, but there is only so much you can do on your own. You must find new comrades on Luxendark, new companions. Comrades who would fight at my side, here in this strange and distant land? Who needs them, I thought. I had already decided this operation would be a lonely one. And yet, the very first person I met here offered to be my friend. I was too happy for words. From one friend followed another. Before I knew it, I had a new mission, a new calling. I want to help you. I want to fight at your side. I want to save Agnes. Together. Do you understand, you? I'm one of Agnes's ball-busting Avengers, just like you.
Magnolia, she's right. The four of us didn't come together just by chance. We're true companions, united by a common cause. A common cause? Yes, that describes us exactly.
To bust the ball, kick the Kaiser's behind,
and rescue Agnes. Together we can do it. We will do it. Let's go for the gravy, everyone!
For the gravy!